Welcome to Haramcore Inc. We have Mumbai's oldest, heaviest stalwarts of the genre, Zygnema in the house. Yes.
We have Sidharth Kadadi, the guitarist, and Leon, the bassist. Today,
sup, man.
Yes.
So, just returned from the Europe tour.
Yes.
How does it feel? I know a couple of shows you all didn't make it.
It was a fucking challenge.
Endurance.
And van breaking down in the land of nowhere, mm-hmm. and then it hurts. You know, you cross the border and enter Switzerland,
mm-hmm.
the most expensive country on this planet.
Right.
And that being a Sunday, and you pay 300 euros just for towing.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, the tour experience I think happened like a lot. I remember once even Sky Harbor had a very major breakdown, accident, lots of shit going down, lot of money going down the drain. People even losing gear and whatnot.
That is the worst. I think I'd read. I think Flesh God Apocalypse's gear
got stolen. That's scary. That's the scary side of touring. But like, tell me what like your experience was in Europe. You all have been there before to play like shows,
yes,
right?
That,
like, but never string of shows. One of you.
Yeah.
So you all went for
Walk-in Inferno. Then we did one small two independent gigs in Germany.
Right.
फिर एक थुप्पट्टी में दुबई का भी शो मिल गया
था।
बैंकॉक वाज यामा एशियन मतलब दैट वाज लाइक अ व्हाट डू कॉल आओ भाई पार्टी करके चले जाओ हम तुम्हारा पैसा लेते हैं।
राइट।
जस्ट गोइंग टू प्ले टू सॉन्ग्स ऑल द वे टू बैंकॉक यू नो getting shit faced and not making it
two songs in Bangkok.
That's the format of
wait, was this like a rock thing?
Yamaha Asian Beat.
Asian Beat
competition. So I think
how long ago was this?
2010. 9 years.
I remember tumne wahan pe bahut party kar liya tha uska bahut story suna hai.
Matlab I can write a new book on Ravi.
Oh yeah, for your reference, Ravi Satpute is the old ex-bassist of Zygnema who's currently in Germany.
And guess what? Today he messaged me saying that he's
Czech Republic.
He's in Czech.
No, he moved to Munich. He was studying in Czech. So obviously he's married and settled in Germany.
He got married also.
Long back. He's got a daughter.
Yeah, congratulations.
Oh yeah.
Today I got to know that he's got a daughter who's 1 year old.
Wow.
I'm like, wow. He's like, I waited for you guys to come to Czech so that I could break the news possibly. Like, bro, we've not even like disbanded and we've not even fought. It's just that you had a peaceful exit, we still talk. Whenever you come, we still jam and have fun. Right. But I guess he knows. Ek saal ki bol raha hai ki meri bachchi ek saal ki hai.
How does that make you guys feel like
old?
Yeah, exactly. Right? But speaking of old, but it's also like a legacy. Probably Bombay's top billing act when it comes to heavy music. They played a string of shows this year as well. Put out a music video recently. And it's now 10, 11 years of existence? 12 years of existence, yes.
13 running. Bolte na. 12 complete, 13 running.
13 running.
Yeah. Running.
And the treadmill is not stopping, I guess, anytime soon.
Hopefully not.
Yeah.
It's slowing down because a lot of personal commitments.
Of course.
Even ours.
Mm-hmm.
The man, Jimmy, became a dad.
Congratulations once
again. Yes.
Jimmy, why go congratulations?
Eating
burgers on the
house. I was really looking forward to having Jimmy over as well.
In fact, I told him, bolta ki, bahut night shift chalo, day shift bhi chalo.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Diaper duties.
You're also getting married.
On 12th of October, yeah.
Very family men. Zygnema is very family men.
I think,
next.
Hopefully, you'll actually shadi kar. I'm going to bitch about him because he's not here. You're supposed to be here, bro. Fuck you.
We'll do a Swayamvar for him, don't worry. I'm going to special edition for him.
But I will organize a big party for him because that man drove almost about 6,000 kilometers in Europe.
Oh, okay.
He was the one.
Huh, so that's a good connect. Tell me more about Europe.
So that the worst part was the car breaking down not once but twice, and then we missing 3 shows. But again, like luckily all of us were on the same wavelength. Nobody was on the verge of emotional breakdown, and nobody was going at each other. Like, you know. हाँ ठीक है यार आज क्या खा रहे हैं वापस मैकडॉनल्ड्स खा रहे हैं इधर खा रहे वही संडास में आ रहे हैं आज क्या दिखने वाला है सिर्फ हाईवे दिखने वाला है और क्या दिखने वाला कुछ नहीं यार वही बेंच एंड मी बीइंग अ वेजिटेरियन आई वाज ओनली ऑन द सेम डाइट लाइक मोजरेला चीज लेटेस्ट टोमेटो सैंडविच हर गेस्ट में वही ठंडा चीज खा रहा हूं आई शुड हैव बीन द फर्स्ट वन टू पंच समवन बट यू नो आई वाज ओके आई वाज हैविंग लकीली नो
हुज द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट टू गेट अलोंग विद हु डजंट प्ले प्ले वेल
वीजा एप्लीकेशन का डेट लॉक करेंगे टिकट करेंगे सब करेंगे उसी दिन पे इसको बोलने का था
But yeah. personal commitments and no details.
तो फिर जो भी सीन होगा ठीक है but then you are like fuck अभी क्या करेगा क्या करेगा तो अभी बेंचो तो अभी जाके
सीन how was it playing with Asim from
it was great man in fact
I spoke to him after he returned because I met him at jam pack he was like bro kya experience tha bahut maza
aaya yeah Asim's been around a while Asim but Asim's yeah he's been around as a musician for a while
exactly.
as a guitarist
yeah. in fact he used to play bass with Jimmy and Asa's yeah. Hindi band called as Safar
yeah.
oh. not the Safar
make Safar. them suffer
make them suffer for the trip
he managed to do a fantastic job in a very short span of time and it was good to have him in ऐसा लगा कि भाई मल्टी लिंग्विस्टिक मल्टी नेशनल बैंड है आसिम को देखे तो द मोमेंट वी लैंडेड बुडापेस्ट एयरपोर्ट यू नो द ड्राइवर ही वाज क्वाइट चैटी सो ही इज आस्किंग आसिम आर यू श्योर यू आर इंडियन
एंड ही इज हाफ चाइनीज
ही इज बट आई उसको पूछ रहा आर यू इंडियन ब्रो माय पासपोर्ट इज इंडियन बट आर यू श्योर यू आर यू इंडियन
आर यू
आसिम छोड़ दे वो कभी नहीं चलने वाला तेरा लेट्स रोल सो यार Missing three shows was gutting.
The bummer, but yeah. What was the good side of it? I'm sure like it must have been a great experience as well.
The culture of people supporting your music and buying merch is phenomenal. Like,
yeah.
We didn't expect to sell so many CDs and t-shirts.
Mm-hmm.
First and second time when we went there, we underestimated the European crowd.
Mm-hmm.
And we just took like what? 3 or 4 boxes of CDs. Like,
right.
100 CDs max. And we found that like 3 dabba wapis aaye.
Right.
But fuck me, like first show pe sab khatam ho gaya tha.
Right.
In 2011.
Does that make Kunal Choksi happy?
Well, unfortunately, if he was,
yeah,
then it would have made him happy. But I think that Kunal Choksi.
But you would have CDs of the last album only, right? Which I think was a
T-shirt. Yeah, but he's been kind to us. He said, okay, I'll help you to retail your CDs.
Right.
Do the T-shirts with them.
Fine. Yeah.
Karo. Kyun nahi yaar? Anything for indie scene.
Mm-hmm.
So, fair,
but yeah, still, like you know, even with my discussions with say Gutslit or Godless and even the Sahil for that matter, like the kind of culture that they have and the kind of support that they give bands, it's almost a like a personal habit for them to like
for them,
attending
it is
shows
like, oh,
to pick up merch.
Yeah,
merch is like kapda hai.
I mean, it's
need clothes and I like this.
This is what you buy.
So I'll buy it.
So people come and say, okay, I want one XL for me, I have tummy, one small for my son who's 13 years old. दो टी शर्ट खरीद रहे बोनी कर रहे
फैमिली स्पिरिट अलग ही है लाइक बिकॉज इवन एन ऑब्सीन एक्सट्रीम लाइक कुलदीप वाज टेलिंग मी लाइक देयर इज लिटरली फैमिलीज वॉकिंग विद देयर किड्स
यस
एंड देयर इज लाइक ग्राइंडकोर ब्लास्टिंग ऑन द स्टेज
They, but yeah, that is kind of their scene, man. It's in their culture, so they don't think of it like, oh, only adults can go to this.
Or like, it's like a guys like, go and do this, and like, you know.
It's so like, I'm family outing mein mall jaate hain, unko
bhi. Yeah, exactly.
I met Vinay's older brother, Vivek.
Oh,
at Informal Oslo.
Okay. Vinay from
Bayanakma. Yeah.
Yes.
So his brother speaks exactly like him, looks exactly like him. Like,
but Norwegian.
No, he's
living there.
He's in.
He lives in Canada.
In
okay.
Canada.
But then you know what he was doing over there? He was researching as a part of his whatever topic or subject in his university. He's a dean in Concordia University.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And he teaches students who are pursuing PhD.
I see. Wow.
So his research topic was life and psychology of black metal musicians.
Wow, interesting.
So over there he was telling me he takes his daughter Maya. He took her first gig was Ghost.
Oh, nice. That's and a good band for
yeah,
a
and then he took her for a Dispatch Icon gig as well. I think so, I'm not sure, but I'll cross it.
Nice. That was quick.
Yeah. That's why you will take her on the shoulder and you know,
nice.
Chalo, metal shows.
Nice.
So, wow, this is making a lot of noise.
No, that's me laughing.
The chair is
laughing with me.
So, yeah, the culture over there is brilliant and he decided, okay, Norway jayega, come see India, theek hai. Log pay what you want karenge. Dekhte hai kitna dete hai. But they're just keeping whatever X amount of money and we realize that that money suffices us to pay our hostel bill and then we could take some and do Ayash in Amsterdam also.
Nice!
So,
that sounds like fun.
So which is why sell more merch.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Also take more merch with you.
Yeah, so basically we Mayank managed to get rid of 8 kilos of food from 4 bags at the airport. Some nikalo aur merch jaate. Sab nikalo aur kichu. So, back says, laddu, chuda, khakara, sab nikalo. Chuck noodles, sab there. Sab there. So, theek hai. Then I had to survive on mozzarella cheese.
Yeah, being a vegetarian must be quite a hard
But thing. Some places you get some amazing falafel. And khana acha hai. But when you're on the road, you have to forget food.
And, yeah. Get by.
How is it living in the van?
Luckily, we just slept in the van twice. Otherwise, the promoter had hooked us up with decent offers where we got a clean space to sleep every
right,
night.
Right.
A clean bathroom to shit.
Right.
So that saved our mental state to quite an extent. Which is why nobody was walking around with a screwdriver to stab anyone.
Yeah, you get a place to lie down and you're like 10 times happier than any other day.
Exactly. And then a lot of venues were so hospitable and they made some great food and fed us. So
nice.
Thank you, no McDonald's. So.
Which was your favorite city to bring out of this entire tour this time now?
Well, I would say three cities in Poland, it was slamming.
Poland.
Two in Germany, especially Gruna. It was more like a house, which had its own bar and a venue. And हम लोग उधर पहुँच के बोला कि what the fuck ये jam room show होने वाला है तो गान लग गए तो थोड़ा downer vibes हो गया था उधर but it's a small town where there are only like 300 people.
Right.
Out of which some 50 people might listen to metal.
Nice.
So, 50 people, 40 people might have showed up. But everybody bought merch. So, you're like, ah.
Nice.
Now we have a reason to smile. Okay. But, I think all the shows were pretty good. And Poland was all the most slamming. And I'll remember this why because 1st of April, Monday, we are playing Poland. And this guy, he posts saying that, okay, 1st of April, a band from India is playing at my venue. But these guys didn't take him seriously. 1st of April, April Fool's
Day. Like,
why should he go to watch a band from India in Poland?
Like, not happening. Yeah.
So he was so stressed that during soundcheck, he was clicking a picture and posting on his group, sending it to people. He's like, hey guys, I have
it's real.
So then, suddenly within 2 hours, they were like, the place was packed and we were like, okay, chalo, like, you know, it'll be fun to play. And Ostro was wild. People were just jumping off the stage, like three guys with long dread, like you know,
right.
Whipping everyone.
Damn, nice.
T-shirt nikal.
Yeah, Leon's feeling bad right
now. Yeah, dude. I feel like
super
proper
form. Super cramped. Arey, school kuch
sawal
puchho
karna.
No. Like,
I couldn't.
Yeah, unfortunately, yeah, bassist might get like you know a little bit of side treatment. Sorry, Azam. That was the number one thing that like, people told us. Like, please, like, Ezra se kuch to, matlab, why is he not saying anything? But yeah.
Ask him gym questions.
Oh, yeah. What about Zygnema? How seriously does Zygnema take fitness and body fitness? Now that y'all are like 12 years going on. Now, how much does fitness matter on stage?
Okay, so yeah.
Muscle mass.
देख मेरे को मेरे दोस्त ने मेरा photo भेजा 2012 में. I was wearing a Joker t-shirt.
Right.
And Joker का face ज़्यादा लंबा लग रहा था. So he comments saying time to hit the gym, get a membership. I'm like yes, I have membership in Vasant, which was bang opposite.
B69. For your reference, Vasant is a bar that used to be open in front of
people. The beauty is we used to not even go and drink there. We used to take hog. Matlab, myself, Hussein, Sean, all of us had become wide.
Right.
Only because you did a lot of dal khichdi, mix veg paratha, and maza. So, itna sugar intake aur kaam jata tha ki
that's very unusual for a bar menu. Like, ye sab order. I remember. I know what you ordered.
Legendary.
I know what. There is one legendary story with Tabby and you guys. I will come back to that. and okay. We will discuss the old days, we'll discuss B69. But let's play some classic cut of, you know, Zygnema right here. Let's play Scarface, and on Haramcore plays up next. Stay tuned, you're listening to Haramcore.
But baad mein what happens, then happens a tragedy. That not everybody wants to spend life with a metalhead. Kya kar raha? Din bhar guitar bajata, okay, tata, goodbye. Then you're like, oh fuck, I play metal, I have no money and I'm fat. What do you do then?
So what happened before the fatness came in? Tell us more about like how Bombay was, like what the vibe was back then when B69 was around. Like I wanted to do a special on just having B69 talk. which I think should happen sometime this year. But
so starting off with B69, big ups to the main man who founded Bhaja, Ashu. So he himself used to play for this band called Zenin, and then the most epic troll band Khiladi.
Yeah, so, which P Man was a part of.
Well, we all can write a separate chapter on Ashu. But then I'll come back to that later. But B69 was a home for all the bands that wanted to play,
right,
but there was no venue, no Raz. Bluecrop wasn't in place at that time.
I think when I came into the scene, I think I saw the last gig of Raz, and then for those 2 years, there were shows happening at that debut when you and Gaurang.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah, debut. Achha yaad dilaya
to. Debut ke baad, I think there were 2-3 shows in debut.
Tribute to the Beast.
Tribute to the Beast, wahan pe ek resurrection hua hai.
Yes.
Album launch, I think, I'm not sure. Workshop album launch.
Few
of those, and then I remember your album launch in some Goregaon place on the first floor.
Kamal Hall.
It's a banquet hall wala scene.
मतलब मैं उधर जाके देखा ड्यूप्ले था मतलब ओह डबल स्टेज नीचे भी ऊपर भी लगे नीचे शादी होएगा ऊपर तुम्हारा प्रोग्राम होएगा
और दोनों हुआ
नहीं लकीली शादी कैंसिल हो गया हमारे शो के पहले कैंसिल हो गया वी वुड हैव बीन रिस्पांसिबल
लाइक तुम में से किसी ने सैबोटेज नहीं किया ना
थैंकफुली नो मैं तो करवा एज अ ब्रिज घूम गया था
उसके पाप लगे रहते हैं यार व्हाट कॉल
दिस आई रिमेंबर दैट एंड देन केम
B69 या सो देन वी यूज्ड टू वर्क व्हेन बजाज टू बी अ स्मॉल ऑफिस फोर पीपल
राइट
आशु माय सेल्फ शॉन एंड रूप बाहर ऐसा आंटी लोग कपड़ा धो रहे हैं छोटा बच्चा पॉटी कर रहे हैं उस पर अंकल लोग पैर रख के फिसल के गिर रहे हैं वो नागरदास चौक में कुछ भी होता था हां हां तो बैठे गिट्टे वाली कैन सी अ पान का स्पिट का भी बूंद कर देगा पचास करे और हम लाइक वाओ लाइक दिस इज व्हाट आई साइंड अप फॉर बट अमेजिंग डेज एंड देन आशु लाइक आई फाउंड अ प्लेस एंड आई थिंक वी कैन डू शोज ओवर देयर चल तो वी ऑल गो वी सी व्हाटएवर देन ही डज दिस थिंग B69 इज सेट अप
राइट
द फर्स्ट गिग वाज बीएम्स कराई बुडी यार 200 लोग घर गए हां
200 लोग घर गए
लाइक दे कुडंट जस्ट गेट इन
जगह ही नहीं और एसी की चार एसी फुल फेस
वो भी तभी दो ही था
जस्ट टू लाइक पिक्चर इट इन योर हेड इफ इफ यू वर इन 2012 11
10-11
in Bombay and if you are attending a big 6-9 show it's basically one small metal staircase a rickety one like that goes up and it's just one hall with barely enough like height like you could punch the wall for the ceiling
it has been punched by Sean and he's drilled a nice hole I think now there are sparrows and pigeons nesting inside so
imagine a place like that with like just your basic AC setup packed and like the sweat of the walls possibly right
yeah and like basically people don't sweat moisture whatever condensation
and BYOB before there was Habitat
yes and that time people would binge on photo
ID then around 200-250 people
max
there was also
we are killing people
that is also 300
yes cheap banter tribute where people had busted lips and Arun busted his forehead man I felt so bad for him and kya ho gaya tere ko
Oh, now we know how it happened.
Mera shirt fat gaya.
Oh,
lucky.
Battle scars.
Yeah, and but before that being B69, it used to be a massage parlor.
Massage parlor.
Oh, Suresh Pujari.
उसके नीचे प्रिंटिंग प्रेस
हां तो वहां से सब ऊपर का प्रिंटिंग एवरीथिंग ऑल जुगाड़ इज इन द सेम वे
डजंट गेट मोर मुंबई देन दिस एक्चुअली
एंड उसके नीचे हनुमान होटल है उसके बाजू में यू हैव सुनील भाई का वाइन शॉप तो सुनील भाई यूज्ड टू गेट वरीड अरे आशु का शो नहीं हो रहा है क्या मैं धंधा नहीं कर रहा
सुनील
भाई यूज्ड टू हैव बियर एंड वाइन
ओनली
ना यूज्ड टू हैव एवरीथिंग क्या बात है Once he realized that people binge on old mom also. See, people like Gary, Bruce, everyone loved their old mom. So, uska, I think old mom
atmosphere. Atmosphere.
Yeah. And Gareth was. It took 4 people to carry Gary.
I remember this. He passed out on
Port Wine
one
time. Juice.
That's the fragrance. You just want it.
Port Wine one time. Log 12 log uthake camp pe laate.
And then next week his wife took revenge on him.
Wow, that's a lot of stories happening, right?
It was like second home. I used to get done with college at 12. I used to be there by 2. Then I used to go back home at 1 in the night.
Then tera story, I want to pull out my favorite tabby story at B69. And this has to do with, I think, Shezwan chakna kuch to aata tha, woh baati mein aata tha.
Oh, chakli.
Chakli and Shezwan, yeah. And woh baati mein, you guys were having drinks and then...
This was Tao, Ravi and Jimmy.
Haan. Oh, yeah. Oh, you were
party Tao.
Definitely Tao.
Flaming shot.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, Shishik Tao, the ex-drummer, Black. Was hanging out with Tabby and...
I was there, I saw it. Kya jala hai, tera mood jala hai ki kya jala
hai? Ibal jala hai, mood jala hai.
He basically got a small
This was after board. Chronophobia, yeah. One that Sate College wala did. We all went to chill at
Yeah. So the story is basically Tammy gets a flaming rum shot. Rum, na? Flaming rum shot in a vati, which is like hot and like it's going to burn him obviously, but he still does it because it's a challenge, and then Tammy burns his precious little moustache.
Peach was back then.
I burned my lip
also.
I drank half of it and the half of it was on the table and the table was on the
And we did this again with Tao at Pritesh's birthday last year. And I burned my moustache.
Wonderful. What are the odds?
It has to be Tao.
Tradition now. Tao is dangerous. You should not get too drunk with it.
Ravi was like, अगर तुमने नहीं किया ना तो इधर तेरे को पीछे से फटके.
So Ravi is known for forcing people to get drunk like that. So going way back 2007, before I left for US, तो Ravi बोला यार आज मेरा पगार आ गया, मैं तेरे को लियोपोल में treat देगा. I said, चल जाते हैं लियो. I used to work at musicians more back then in marine lines.
Okay.
तो close by, Ravi bhai treat de raha hai, maine jab mein 200 rupaya.
Right.
Uske jab mein pura salary tha, usse jo bhi tha.
Right, yeah.
So we go and buy a pitcher of beer, we are having and then suddenly we hear a familiar voice. Hey, Binchut, chale. Mujhe murke dekha to main Judas Gupta baitha. He's finished his BMS exam and he was really happy and
I but that's like really long ago.
Exactly. I just joined the table. So his friends pitched him and they had like a huge tower of beer. And Riju was already hammered, I guess.
Uh-huh.
And then Ravi bola, bhai, beer. Riju ko bula le gaya.
Opportunity.
So Riju aage baithi, hum log beer mast pee rahe hain. Riju out ho gaye. To Ravi bolta hai, yaar yaar tu abhi BMS exam diya hai, bada aadmi banega. Chal, Gokul chalte. Udhar tu treat dega. Ah, main treat dega. Hum log gaya.
Uska treat kya Riju ka
treat bana. That is Ravi. So we reach Gokul and Ravi like क्या महंगा बियर पीता है कैनन 10,000 मंगा है सिंगल और सुपर लाइक बेसिकली ही इज कॉलिंग फॉर टर्पेंटाइन व्हिच इज फ्लेवर्ड लाइक बियर
डेथ
एंड देन रिजू मैनेज टू लाइक यू नो स्टंबल एंड रीच द शेडी टॉयलेट टू टेक अ लीक गोस टू ब्लड बिटर हो रहा है एक अल्काजर 30 ले गया तो रिजू के ग्लास में उसने वोडका डाल दिया बियर ग्लास में सो ही कांट सी इट तो रिजू हैज चक्ड दैट तो ही इज गिवन सम सेंटी टू बोथ ऑफ अस लाइक यू नो प्यार क्यों नहीं करना चाहिए यो सम बोल के तो आई विल नॉट डिस्क्लोज द डिटेल रिजु खुद बताएगा
ऑलरेडी आई डाउट इट बट इन इनविटेशन टू रिजु प्लीज फाइट यू रिजु एट जैम पैक प्लीज क्लेरिफाई
सॉरी रिजु अभी तो तेरा डब्ल्यूडब्ल्यूई मूव आ गया
इट डजंट हैव टू बी पब्लिक बट दे नीड टू आई वांट टू आस्क लियोन व्हाट
वाज लियोन वेयर वाज लियोन बैक देन
हां
अपार्ट फ्रॉम सिस्टम
वाज आई वाज या प्लेइंग विद सम
बोल दे कि मैं बोलूं
क्या तभी तो
बहुत डेंजर बैंड
है हां 2007 एंड ऑल आई डोंट नो वेदर आई वाज प्लेइंग विद एनीवन एट दैट टाइम मे बी जस्ट स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग
क्रिप्टोनिक क्योस
हां आई स्टार्टेड ऑफ प्लेइंग विद
क्रिप्टोनिक
क्योस
बोथ द
राइट
ओके के
के कल्ट वाला
यू आर द मेटल के बट आई यू आर द बैंड कॉल्ड क्रिप्टोनिक
हर्ष यूज्ड टू आल्सो सिंग फॉर अ हिंदी बैंड विद अ लेफ्टी डिंग गिटार कॉल्ड एज रू
रू या
हां रू पता है
सो ही हर्ष वाज द गिटारिस्ट एंड ही यूज्ड टू प्ले विद रिडेम्पशन आई थिंक All of them,
right?
Because we used to meet at gigs and all that.
But I think that's a cool thing. Like when y'all were contemporaries in that scene, there were a lot of people playing music.
Yeah.
A lot of people who picked up instruments. A lot of people who wanted to form bands, be there at shows. Yeah. how does that feel like? You're an instructor now.
Yes.
So what do you feel about then and now? You know, what's changed? What do you feel is
what's missing? People have lost their perseverance, I feel.
Mm-hmm.
It's very hard to put all of them on stage. Even if I've tried organizing two or three student gigs,
mm-hmm.
you know, they just back up. Like, oh, nigga, I done like that.
Do you feel it's a generational shift? It's like
change? Yes, it is. In fact, I've been teaching so many students, out of which only, like, you know, three of them have taken up music seriously.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And they're doing pretty well for themselves. But back then, if you go to see, Timir has taught most of the guitar players in Bombay.
And that's what I want to touch upon. So, you come from a background being in a metal band, mm-hmm. and you inspire other people to pick up instruments and start their own bands.
Yes.
But we try. That happened with Timir. Do you see that happening with you, like, you know, in the future? Could you tell that? Like, can you?
Well, at least I've seen some progress in the past 5 years. That
right.
some of them have graduated from acoustic guitar to electric,
right.
who are wanting to. Take extra efforts and at least start jamming
right.
with a few people.
Right.
And if that kicks off, then you
it
know,
might
yeah.
be something.
But
yeah.
then everybody has such a different tangent, and the kind of shit that we're being fed with in today's time.
Mm-hmm.
I think everybody has become a screenier. You know, they're spending like
passive.
Jada time
yeah.
screen by the back in the day, like, you know, I used to have 26 kbps dial-up internet.
I mean, I was just sure. I'm like, old days. Oh,
yeah. I'm not landline. I'm not phone. Kare hai, Like, actually, even a YouTuber is, like, you know, he'll sit and, like, yes. takes 10 lessons off YouTube,
right.
not giving a fuck about techniques or the theory behind it.
Yeah.
Log bole, "Ah, theek hai, main baja hai, mere ko switch chalo maina aata hai, main band banaya." Theek hai,
bana. Mere ko gaana aata hai. But, you know, music.
Brother, like, you, know, you need to learn how to understand other human beings and
right.
work with them, function with them, because band is just not a band, it's a fucking family.
It's a band. Yeah. It's a lot of personal relationships.
And it's just like you might play 24 shows in 12 months, which is still a decent number. But then, you know, in that one whole year, there might be some serious incident where, you know, they need you, or a happy moment where you have to just jump
be there
and be there.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Even that kind of bond is missing between people. Everyone just, they're spending time on text, but like, kya bakchudi kar raha hai, mil doston ko bahar ja. Like, we still like hanging out. Like,
that's a very, I would say it's a very characteristic of metalheads.
Yeah.
I mean, of all the stereotypes that people can pin on a metalhead, it's one of the good ones. You know, it's a great one. That sense of brotherhood, community, like, you know, this is us,
yeah.
we have our family.
Whoever, man, like, even if it's an old friend from school, if you're, like, you know,
right,
okay,
right.
like, social media is there for you all to connect. With each other, जब चढ़ती है कोई pilot बन गया और New Zealand में settle हो गया, बोल रहा है bro,
like थोको,
but he's like, hey bro, I'm coming to India,
तू आएगा तो हाँ, मिलेगा,
मतलब you're fucking shattered tiffin box with him, मतलब तू उसको वो तेरे को तेरा पहला Brian Adams का tape दिया था,
right,
he's not playing guitar, he's flying aeroplane,
right,
but he gave you that tape which has instigated you,
right,
they look at you that way कि भिंचो मेरे को लगा कि तू सिर्फ guitar सुन के खुश होएगा, अभी you're actually living that life,
right,
so they are more excited because somewhere, you know, they have instigated that.
Right.
Get out and fucking sit with them. Baat karo, ghar pe jao, khana khao, daru pe, kuch bhi karo, lekin.
But chill.
That's a very unique, like, you know, point of view that we've had. We've never had this kind of a, I guess, such a serious discussion on, you know. I mean, that's fine. That's fine. It's a great.
It's actually.
It's a great
thing from first
one. Yeah.
Exactly. Right.
So again, when you say.
Reality.
B6 time पे भी क्या होता था? Like वो time पे तो चल ठीक है, like people would ask me, तेरे फोन पे WhatsApp नहीं?
वाह!
क्या use कर रहा है तू? भाई मैं Nokia C3 use कर रहा हूँ, Java पे चलता है, Android नहीं। मेरे को phone कर,
Right.
So then that it used to be a hangout spot. Like, tabhi isa WhatsApp group nahi tha. Tabhi ek dusre ko G-top pe ping karne ka ya landline se phone karke chutiya banane ka. So I pulled off this prank on Shehza. I called him from my office landline. I think he was playing one of his Providence League in Ahmedabad. I spoke to him in Gujarati. Tamara Providence se kya kon baat kar raha hai kon hai picture kon hai अब सोच रहा था मेरे बच्चे का बर्थडे पार्टी है बजाओ एक बर्थडे पार्टी वाला नहीं बजाता आई कॉल्ड हिम अगेन मेरा बेटा बहुत बड़ा फैन है आपका प्लीज मैं बर्थडे पार्टी नहीं बजाता दिन भर ये कॉल्ड हिम अपना अंकल मारो क्यों फोन कर रहा है कैनेडी बोल बहुत मारे एंड ही वाज इन अहमदाबाद प्लेइंग शो लाइक ठीक है मतलब अपना दोस्तों का मतलब टाइम पास करेगा
But yeah, I guess that's the thing, you know, you guys were lucky to be actually, in an era where you all were connected.
That, yeah.
You all had a hangout where you all could go and like, you know, just bond in general.
More importantly, back in the day, colleges used to push Battle of the Bands in.
That's another thing, you know.
It's
something like, gone. Like, you know, Unchained and stuff, like the kind of memories
people have. Unchained, Power Chords, what was that? The SIS
Nerul. That's Power Chords, if I'm not wrong. But
उधर मेरे को याद है ऐसा हम लोग को विनिंग मैच में रैट गिटार मिला था फ्लाइंग वे सा
सिग्रा वाले जेटी
दिस इज मैं ऐसा टूर किया सिंगिंग में पता है ऐसा एक हफ्ते में चार कॉलेज
यू टॉकिंग टू
लाइक या दैट वाज द नेक्स्ट हैंगआउट सीन
कल फॉर एवरीवन ये कॉलेज याद है अपन उधर जाके
सो वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस विद अदर थॉट्स ऑन द ब्लैकलर पॉडकास्ट एपिसोड लाइक एवरीवन वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस लाइक यू नो वी यूज्ड टू गो कॉलेज कंपटीशन टू कंपटीशन Just do a tour of string of like college shows just to watch the band. Like there was an audience.
So ये competition है कर रहा है like
हाँ
कर रहा है.
ये हुआ.
ये भी पता है. तो वजह है कि हाँ हम लोग भी वजह थे we'll chill
there. So Ashwin tried to sell me this like you know I will get you a headlining slot. You headline that college and we'll play the competition we'll win it. चल ठीक है good deal. So Ashu gets me a headlining slot, but guess what? The headlining slot ka fees is half of the winning price.
You are playing the obvious switch.
And then Jimmy like, "Bichu ko chutiya hai." Hum log compete kar rahe hain. So wo baat pe, mujhe office mein log best chal raha hai. Tum log compete nahi karna hai. Log kitna compete karega? Bichu tum log abhi headline karo. हमको कंप्लीट करने के लिए हम लोग पहला राउंड निकला नहीं हमको पहला राउंड के लिए पैसा चाहिए
तो
tight competition man and we remember
there are so many bands so many musicians
I remember at the same time atmosphere Zygnema
Abraxas
Abraxas ye sab log aisa ek
saath informal rod devoid black
right.
then
mai mazaa hai
matak masala story for the but then IIT like when you're talking about playing competitions back to back we played two elimination rounds the same day तो दोपहर को पावर कॉर्ड बजाए एंड देन वी लाइक पैसा भागा स्ट्रेट टू आईआईटी बॉम्बे वी लाइक मुड़ा है जीतने का मुड़ा म्यूजिक बजाने का मुड़ा है बजाने का एंड देन रोजमेरी बैक इन द डे किलर साउंडिंग
बट वाज दिस हाउ लाइक अराउंड दिस टाइम लाइक यू ऑल गॉट द फंड्स टू लाइक पुट बॉन ऑफ यूनिटी टुगेदर
बॉन ऑफ यूनिटी तो घर पे रिकॉर्ड किया
राइट
सो व्हाटएवर
मनी
So we saved that money so that like you know abhi what to do with this okay. So that money definitely came handy to do the second album and
right.
to get merch printed and like you know right, right. Yeah. probably if we wanted to buy some gear
right.
so
of course gear upgrades all of that happens, so yeah.
yeah we had that kind of relief so we never even for jam like we never put money from our pockets
yeah. that's sweet
so man. Which is why we would bank on these competitions
right
and yeah so we had to make that IIT happen and Rosemary back then so they put our slamming gig hum log phat gaye और साहिल जज था तो साहिल जी मेरे को देखो ए इज वेयरिंग चप्पल और डिटर्ट मार्क्स
यस यस क्लासिक क्लासिक
साहिल जी मेरा जिमी मादा जो है लौड़ा बिच्चो तो टिपिकल लॉन्ग हेयर आई डोंट नो हम लोग जीतेगा टाइप्स बट देन चलो ठीक है वी गॉट टू प्ले लाइक 4-5 songs, whatever competition. It started raining.
Oh shit.
And then back in the day, it was Slain who was playing with us.
Oh, nice. From Bangalore, right.
And Bryden is a beast on the instrument. Yeah. All of them. Even Jared Sandy, who's playing for Inner Sanctum now.
Mm-hmm.
They played one song. I still have goosebumps when I talk about that. Mm-hmm. They played one song.
I was there at the
game. And we just look at each other like,
yeah.
Like, you just know because they are so fucking good.
Right.
And when they walked down, I said, Bryden, fuck it. And he was using some Zoom pedal and he had got some crazy tone, man.
That reminds me of when I was playing a competition and Orchid came on stage. Like, we spoke about this when we had a conversation with Orchid on the previous podcast. Mm-hmm. Even they're like mind blowing. Like, they came in the college competition circuit and most bizarre band out there. But like, they just go through
every way. When you sound different, obviously people
take attention and very proficient, like very good at their instruments.
I think Mikey used to play for the band, no? Abhishek Michael?
No. That's
Shepard.
I'm so sorry. But yeah, I mean, like, it's been a long journey since then to now with the last album, and now y'all are working on new material and stuff. So yeah. I want to touch upon, like, you know, what's up in the Zygnema camp next. So
writing new material, yes. Yeah. It's slowed down a little bit, obviously.
Because a lot of family commitments come.
Yeah.
And you know, that
I want to talk about that as well, like how y'all have changed over time and how that's influencing probably the music.
Hmm.
So we'll touch base upon this. Let's take a quick break right now and go back to Haramcore Plays. We'll be playing two tracks of acts from the Indian scene. We've got War Marshals, Vanguard, and we've got Trash Talk from Bangalore's Revenge of Meenakshi.
Nice name. I'm a fan already.
Check it out. You're listening to Haramcore. Stay Haramcore. We'll be right back.
fucking amazing.
Zygnema, and we're talking, you know, we touched upon a lot of fun past stories, like, you know, how even Zygnema and as a band, as people, they've changed, the effort that they put in, you know, on the initial releases, all the Vasant stories, but yeah, talking about what's up right now and, like, you know, how, where you guys are as people and how things have changed in the last 6-8 years.
Priorities changed.
Right.
Yeah, but then, like, touch wood.
The band stays.
Yeah, the heart is still in the same place.
Right.
Like, the frequency might have gone down.
Right.
And I hope this won't stay the way it is for too long.
Mm-hmm.
But we all know each other's priority and commitment, right. So we respect.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's the most important thing, which is why, like, you know,
mm-hmm.
we have been the way we are for 13 years.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, it feels great that, you know, whenever you go on stage, you're seeing the same face. Yeah, we miss Ravi,
mm.
And then this bugger had to happen.
Mm.
So it's a great feeling, like, you know, we've never like tried auditioning for
right.
anyone. We just meet people, they're like, fuck.
You're a guy. Tu apna banda hai.
Tu cool banda hai aur tu apne jaisa sasta aadmi hai aur tu cutting chala raha hai aur tu kaam chala le ja.
Sasta lag rahi
hai. Matlab like no fancy habits.
No high maintenance people. Like, and that's again, once again, you know, something you said. You have to deal with people, and people need to be accommodating,
yeah.
deal with each other and, like, you know, work together.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, like, difference of opinion is still okay, like, you know, and it's great that, like, at least people are thinking.
Mm.
And then when you rack your brain, then okay, fine, you come to a conclusion. But it's not been that it should not be done. Yeah. So, thankfully, kabhi hua. So, it's great. It's a great feeling. As people, yes, we were skinny, then we became fat, and then we realized, okay, fuck, we are fat, drunk, broke, so let's do something with us and not look so shabby.
Right.
So that's how we have changed.
Physically changed, ke alawa, like, you know, of course, like, you know,
Mayang has become Bollywood, man. But I'm happy.
But
he's touring
the most.
Yeah.
So that's why
he's there. But
yeah, he's playing the most.
Driving
more
than
that, right? Driving.
What's up with Leon?
I said we were supposed to.
He was supposed to.
You were the designated driver.
No,
yes,
like,
we
were, okay, now there are three designated drivers.
Jimmy doesn't
drive. Jimmy doesn't drive.
Jimmy
doesn't. He only likes Uber.
Yeah.
I only like my Bullet and my Mumbai auto.
Right.
So
bike scene.
So Bacha, Mayank, Mayan, Akash.
Right.
So Asim drove for a bit.
Mm-hmm.
But then उसको पीछे
को ड्यूटी ले लिया थोड़ा सा
हाँ थोड़ा सा लिया
7,000 में से 5,500 मयंक चला है बाकी थोड़ा सा बचा हुआ है आसिम थोड़ा चला है तो yes unfortunately his visa got rejected twice and at the same time the moment we landed in Croatia no we reached Croatia BC Sky was updated you know even their visa got rejected so then when we reached Switzerland so we met a guy and he it could be a probability, I could be wrong, but he said ki, like, you know, the Brexit thing has come into a lot of focus and a lot of Brits are being sent back from Europe. A lot of Europeans are coming back to
Europe.
Yeah, so I was like, oh, so that is the reason. And, and it's highly impossible for Akash's visa to get rejected because he travels the most. And internationally. And he's got, I think he's still an active US visa. I don't know.
Yeah, I think he does. Yeah. And in fact, his passport...
Yeah. Aditya, then he, he's doing Amit Mishra also.
Yeah, yeah. And his passport was just full, right?
Yeah, so basically he, we so, waited to apply for a visa so that he said, "Arey, mera passport ka sab khatam ho gaya. Mere ko naya passport lage." So he applied.
It's a new one, yeah.
So he got a new passport.
He didn't get it.
And in spite of that, yeah.
So this tour was pure Hamali. And we are doing each other sound also. Arey, theek hai, tera kya chahiye na? Theek hai, pata nahi kya naam ghumare, but achha lag raha hai.
Don't you think that's what's missing in today's scene? Maybe, you know, that kind of builds character. Like
it does. It
you
does.
You are. We are so pampered in the Indian scene where we expect so much and do so little as bands. But when you go there, you like you're the hot
dog. Carry your own amps. You have to set up your own.
I mean, yeah, apart from the physical aspect of it, you have to manage your time. You have to manage yourselves as band.
Specifically, and everything is cut to.
And so, when chill karne ka time nahi hai, direct pack karo. Yeah. Apko nikalne ka, we have to go to
that. You have to be smart with how you chill also. You can't just go crazy every night and like kill yourselves.
Which is why, like, you know, the first time when I saw that Alive DVD, 2008 or 2009, that is when Hackstrom said in the video, like, you know, it all looks cool, party and shit, but in real life it's not that. You get tired and sick of seeing the same shit and you walk and you actually start missing your home.
Right.
So udhar tour ke mein wohi bol raha hai, mere ko jet spray chahiye. Mere ko mera dal chapati chahiye.
Exactly.
But
yeah, dude, like you ordered that in Vasan, matlab tu hardcore, matlab ghar ka like khana mat dude.
Yeah. But then like the boys are surprised, like you being a vegetarian, you didn't flip, you were still eating that trash for so long and you survived.
Because you don't have, like, I mean, when you're on the road, you don't have the liberty. You don't have restaurant,
gas station.
Exactly.
You only see moving objects.
Right.
And suddenly when you enter city, you're like, and like so many cars. Oh, we lane, they are bhai, idhar ko hai bhai. So it's
a shift in
world. Yeah, it's so weird that you're like traveling in that same van for such a long time. When you get off the van sometimes and you're just sitting in a chair, it's not moving, but you feel like you're bouncing.
We used to feel like that with Rajdhani.
Railway effect. I was just going to say that only. Railway effect. Like, you hugne jata hai aur tu fir bhi aisa aisa hai.
Leon has been outside of it. System has done it.
Yeah, exactly. Even System has done quite a number of tours.
He played with Chris Barnes.
Oh yeah, yeah. 60 Runner. Yes, famous target of memes and jokes on the internet. But legend nevertheless.
On the entire tour, only him and someone else got to meet him.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Banta kya sir? Scoop.
He's actually a very he's a very nice. He's not a people's person. That's the fucking. He's a very nice guy.
He took 20 seconds to respond and say yes. Yeah. So I saw a lot, dude.
So you could compete, like him and Phil Anselmo would still win the race.
Phil Anselmo, I think Ravi met him, and in fact Ravi went back to chill with him when he played pool and all that.
Oh, nice.
So Ravi, and then. So then to compensate, he sent a picture of Max Keller holding a CD.
That's cool.
So khun maaf. Bada ye maaf hai. Abhi tu Max ko de de matlab ho gaya darshan ho gaya apna. But then yeah, the when you ask, like, you know, how does it feel to sleep in a van? So one great incident that I just remembered is after that massive car breakdown and shelling so much money, we went back to Italy by train, so just so that accommodation is cheaper over there.
Right.
Fir office aake, alag van utha ke, then we went. We played a show, then we were on our way to Strasbourg in France. So then we just parked in the normal parking, chilling. So rahe hum log, subah ke 4 baje aaya Swiss border patrol, uthaya hum log. Okay, documents, passport diya. Wo police wale usse slight muhav ke sath tha, pura start tha. Torch maar ke dikh rahe gaadi ke andar. Hey, you guys are bad? Yes. Like what, a boy band? Ungli kar raha. He knows, and he himself is a metalhead.
Right.
No, 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 we play heavy metal, but oh, metal. तो सब पासवर्ड दूसरे ऑफिसर को दिया जाके तू कर व्हाट्स योर बैंड नेम तो सर्च करा मैंने बोला मैं इंशुद proof check kar raha hai ki background dikha rahi kya kar raha hai then he's listening to song the jeevi ka nahi hota isko cd deke khatam kar yaar so cd de dena no we can't take this value out of work but yeah I like I listen to your music नहीं जस्ट टेक इट जस्ट अ सीडी ठीक है दूसरा वाला बोला मेरे को भी चाहिए उसको भी दिया
मैं सुनता नहीं हूं सीडी चाहिए
अपॉर्चुनिटी साला
और दूसरा वाला ही सेड लाइक यू नो वी डोंट हैव ब्लूटूथ इन आवर कार सो दिस विल वर्क बोल सही है 5 मिनट में काम खत्म तो बोलता है द कॉप्स ओवर देयर आर क्वाइट विजिलेंट दे विल चेक वेरी प्रोफेशनल एंड दे विल विश यू एंड दे विल गो अवे
या But then the thing that Jimmy said is like very. That's
a very Indian. The most Indian. It's an
icebreaker.
और एक तो हम लोग नींद में उसको अपना बैंड का नाम बोल रहा है उसको समझ में नहीं आ रहा स्पेलिंग बोल रहा है तो हम लोग जेड बोलते हैं लोग जी बोलते हैं एंड बेसिकली स्विट्जरलैंड में द पीपल स्पीक थ्री लैंग्वेजेस ओवर देयर लाइक दे स्पीक फ्रेंच जर्मन एंड इटालियन बोला यार अभी वो पहले पूछा यू स्पीक डॉयच बोला नो 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 डॉयच नथिंग हिंदी मराठी इंग्लिश ऑब्वियसली ओनली वन ऑफ
रीड स्पीक
लाइक बट ओला यार यू स्पीक इंग्लिश सो ही वाज थ्रो इनटू द लैंग्वेज सो दैट कन्वर्सेशन हैपेंड रियल क्विक First gig, fucking we got caught and we had to pay a fine. Romania. Because we didn't have the vignetta. They didn't have toll, so you have to buy a vignetta. We didn't find a gas station. पहले शो के पहले पकड़ लिया है जो हम लोग बार्गेन कर रहे उसको इंग्लिश समझते नहीं बार्गेन क्या करेगा नहीं भाई तू 180 यूरो दे स्टिकर ले और कल्टी हो मैं बोला नहीं नहीं बताओ कि ठीक है यू कलेक्ट योर पासपोर्ट यू पे मनी वायर ट्रांसफर देन टेक योर पासपोर्ट मैं बोला तू क्या बोल रहा है मतलब पासपोर्ट टू यू
Zygnema डीलिंग विद कॉप्स इन मुंबई एंड इन यूरोप वेट स्टाइल सबसे हसलर बैंड इंडिया का बोले तो Zygnema समझ के समझ जाओ पट्टा है
अनफॉर्चूनेटली वी डिडंट हैव ओल्ड मॉन्ग एंड बीडीज And it's legal to even like some countries like you know they entertain okay TV even drink on the street fine
but, yeah they do fuck yeah. that was a different discussion yeah, altogether yeah. yeah but yeah I mean like just to touch upon like how things have changed I mean like we have a lot of respect for Jimmy I mean I wish he was here we could get his take on like how things have changed exactly right like from starting his burger chain like I think every self-respecting metalhead has gone there and had one of those burgers and there are so many now and so they're so good and yeah it's like so a legacy in itself
started with some small space which was possible
exactly like
this nobody started on a cart
in Sangli Jimmy is from Sangli
yeah
and we got our first signature Zygnema pick made from Sangli
wow
तो सांगली से बहुत कुछ आता है
दैट्स अ स्टोरी इन इटसेल्फ आई होप टू गेट हिम ऑन द पॉडकास्ट यू नो जस्ट वन ऑन वन सम टाइम यू नो
यस वंस इज किड इज अ लिटिल बिग सो वंस ही नोज ओके फाइन लाइक यू नो
मामा बनके कैसा लग रहा है
Yeah, I'm putting it in a cage.
Okay, good for
me. Make sure Spinner doesn't watch this
podcast. Yeah, it was like really great to, you know, go through all your experiences as a band, as individuals over the last 10, 12, 15 years. And how it's like, you know, changed you guys and like, you know, your approach to things and how you guys are still persevering. I think that's the one core idea around which all our conversations today revolve around, like, you know, be it kids who want to pick up instruments or be it what Zygnema is doing today and tell us more about what's in store. You all put out a new video single with a very strong message.
Yes.
And like what's the new material going to be like?
So I think we have written a couple of songs but then you know it's been hard for us to actually schedule jams because everyone's been all over the place.
Right.
And whenever we jam we're like last time kya kiya tha. So it's we are in that space. So
how much do you all coordinate digitally? Because that's the new thing, right? So
yeah.
If band members are unavailable or in different parts of the country even now, everyone works on demos, shares demos, learns stuff at home, and then like you know shows up for.
Yeah, yeah. So that happened from the second album because that's where I started getting quite awesome with drum programming.
Right, right.
So
yeah.
Once that happened, I was like, I can actually like make his voice sound like and give them the sound like what my what my idea is. And then obviously it helps them to also come up with better ideas.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one great thing that like, you know, everybody has always contributed to a lot of things and
mm-hmm.
it's just not been like, okay, Silviska sound, I also sound. It's
right.
a collective
right.
sound.
And even changing, you know, to this, so, I mean, I get that you guys are very old school, like all the discussion like is centered around like your, how you guys do stuff as a band.
Mm-hmm.
So to shift
yeah.
from like being the guys who used to hang out every day and jam like 4 or 5 times a week to like now, you know, maybe you all don't get enough time, but you all figure out with demos and stuff. To adapt is another, you know, key aspect of...
It wasn't actually that difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Matlab, it was like a revelation,
mm-hmm.
like, oh,
mm-hmm.
okay, kaam faster hai, jam pe paise kam kharche.
Yeah, we were coming, we realized that we are coming to the jam room
prepared, yeah. And
because otherwise, you are coming there and we're sitting, acha, mere dimaag mein ye hai, acha, mere ko dikha, acha, tu ye baja raha hai, main bola, acha, ye, acha, he programs drums, he records guitars over that, it sends, so we already have an idea of what the drum
needs to sound like. So, but have you realized we are going backwards again?
Yeah, yeah, actually, since
I
have
written 5 songs,
uh-huh.
and I am nothing picture में भी नहीं था.
Right.
पांच ने सबको भेजा है. हर एक गाने का एक-एक part अच्छा लग रहा है. लेकिन पूरा गाने में सब कुछ बैठ के किसी ने काम नहीं किया.
Right.
मैं वेदर फटा भी गया. Then suddenly we are just jamming. Then एक riff, दो riff, तीन riff बना. फिर वो एक गाना 3-4 jam में बन गया. मैं fuck, it sounds great.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's
go ahead.
Let's record and see how it's going to sound.
Right.
तो एक गाना बन गया. And then मैंने आज जब मैं बाकी गानों के देखेंगे बाद में. But then,
do you all guys feel like a lesser incentive to put out albums because even listeners have changed? People.
Not exactly, because if I start viewing it that way, if we'll start viewing it that way, then you know, we might probably lose out on the interest because, like, one thing that is holding us together is that we still share the same drive that, fuck, we put out an album and. We want to hear it so that we get bored of it before we start playing that long story.
And it's a milestone.
I think that is the thing with all the bands. Like,
I mean,
it's about the mixing and mastering process.
With every jam, it's one more repetition of the same thing, right?
Yeah, but then you know what happens? Like, we played the same fucking 16, 17, 18 song, whatever, on the tour.
Mm-hmm.
But then it felt amazing to play those songs
mm-hmm.
because we're doing it day in and day out.
Right.
It felt like a fucking day job, like, you know, fuck, drive, play, new people.
There's a purpose.
Yeah, new people, new audience, new faces, new expressions.
Mm-hmm.
And though, like, language was a barrier, but.
Mm-hmm. That didn't stop.
The feeling was great.
Right.
And, like, when people come to you and respectfully want to buy your merch and your CDs, like, you know, they are representing your work.
Mm-hmm.
And I was, like, we are genuinely grateful. And, lot of people also came up and helped us with a lot of things.
Right.
And when they would read about, you know, our van breakdown issue, this issue, that issue, then, you know, they would genuinely do stuff for us. And, you know, we are truly grateful to them. And, again, coming back to the songwriting bit. So, you know, we usually take time to write an album because we all get into the face key and fuck it, it's a lot of show. Main just giving me fuck pura saal nikal
gaya yeah, some time yeah. right some
you said the frequency is not
on it that decadence to all over India
yeah. exactly yeah. you all say frequency kam ho gaya ghanta ho gaya you are doing well don't cut yourself so much slack
no, we don't.
Cut yourself more slack
but see college gigs
mm-hmm.
are not happening and
that won't now if the whole scenario changes but I think what's great what lies ahead is that now bands are actually plugging multiple cities and doing tours because there are clubs open to gigs.
Yeah,
You can get programmed now much better than what you would probably 5 years ago or 8 years ago.
I think I feel the other way. It's okay. But
mm-hmm.
What happens is back in the day we didn't have like Raz was shut. We didn't have B69.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't
right.
have. So even the kids in college would feel ki apne college mein metal show
mangta. Mangta right.
3-4 metal ad college mein rahega na wo. GS बनने हैं क्यों मेरे को टॉप मेटल बैंड्स लाने का सो दे विल फ्रीकिंग गेट अ इन्फर्नल दे गेट एन एक्सुमेशन एंड बैक इन द डे लाइक यू नो वी वुड गो एंड फकिंग फैन बॉय ओवर ऑल दीस बैंड्स लाइक
बट देन दैट्स द थिंग नाउ योर ऑडियंस हैज ग्रोन ओल्डर दे आर द वंस कमिंग टू क्लब्स दे आर नॉट डूइंग शोज एट कॉलेजेस एनीमोर व्हिच इज व्हाई यू आर गेटिंग यू कैन स्टिल गेट एन ऑडियंस एट क्लब्स एंड यू कैन प्ले क्लब्स अक्रॉस द कंट्री
या बट यू नो in between, we had done this mixed effort with Black and Koshish. That was party.
Right.
So that whole initiative was to play to a new audience. Right. And what will it take? To what extent can we go? Mm. And that whole journey of that three bands
working together. Very well promoted. Very well.
And we were selling tickets for 200 rupees.
Right.
Early bird. And at the
reminds gate, us of stuff we did in Pune. But
yeah. At the gate, if you are late, then pay 400 bucks. Mm. But it was still a nominal price, and we were selling Kingfisher big can for 150 bucks.
Right. So value for
everything is
possible. Experience. It's an experience and it's value.
People, I think there were about 550 people for that game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The amount of chicks that showed up that time. Mm-hmm. All metalheads went bonkers. We were like, "Where are we?"
And that this is a metal show.
Yeah, exactly.
It wasn't. No, that's the point of it.
Because the name was Party Lala.
Right.
So some.
But they enjoyed it.
Because of that, like now we have some new people coming to gigs.
Oh wow, okay.
So
that's just sweet.
And we need to do, again we did that non-dependence gig. Again we had some 15-20 people who came from O&M, some people came from Schubert company, kaun sa hai?
Oh shit, I don't
know. Right. Basically from world, people are now attending Zygnema shows.
And Schubert is like this... Mm-hmm.
Schubert, right.
He buys
merch for all the bands.
I know. He'll buy for his colleagues also. Tubi pen, show. My tera ticket ka paisa bhar.
Right.
So like such enthusiasts still exist. So you have to, like you know, I think, reach out to them and tell them, hello, we exist.
Right.
Because even they are just locked in their own space.
They don't discover much. Yeah.
Yeah, and everything, as I told you, there's a lot of information overload happening everywhere.
Right.
And considering all the big brands putting in so much money in digital space, all the real organic good things that people want to discover is being blocked out.
Right.
So, we bands are left with no money.
Mm.
And putting 50,000 rupees in Facebook is pointless.
Right.
So, which is why this was the way out. Like, you know, all the bands met together.
Right.
We had like a big 15-member meeting where everyone's drawing out their corporate list. Such amazing times, like you know, when you think about it, it was that 1 month passed by like 1 week.
Yeah, and we also
went to
so many places. That was
even if band members
were
not available,
you filled each other's songs.
So we had to play some 6 busking sets on the same day.
Right.
So we made 3 groups. So this group, So then Mangesh called me and said, "Bro, you like play a song? Sikhiye, mere ko bahut man kar raha hai." "Okay, chal, play a song, bajayenge." So it was just a no-brainer. Just go and have fun. Tell people that you know. You all are musicians, you like having fun. If you all enjoyed, please come.
Right. And it's collaborative.
Yeah.
That's I think a very great insight. Like once again, another, what do you call, feather in the hat, I would say. Something, trying something new, something different. Yeah. A lot of metal bands are stuck up, they don't want to try things that are new.
Just collaborate.
Yes. I mean, it boils down to that. So.
And if you work together, like, you know, it's like more hands, more brains, more eyes, more ears.
Yeah.
Hoping to do one gigantic collaboration again.
I would say even the Mumbai band gig was one of my favorites from like last year. So definitely.
I think it was
awesome.
Like, I think the way it like it started with the whole
the article.
The article.
It was promoted.
It was super.
And after a while there was a gig happening at Habitat, and even we had taken a small break. Like, we said okay, let's wait it out and play at the right time. And that's what we're doing right now. We don't want to immediately jump into the wagon of it. Let's tour India again. Like,
right.
So I want the Reform Rebirth tour to happen in India as well. But let's see. Like you know, now though I can't because you know Jimmy can't come like this for all our shows.
Right.
Otherwise, you know, all of us will get slaughtered.
Yeah, now I'm gonna make the most of this time and
go back to the old stuff that we have written.
Yep.
Hopefully. Reject Motor.
That's
what's up. Go to inbox. Search for.
I will send the file again.
So we'll
give you guys a glimpse of that. And when I say glimpse, I mean it because for the first time, we're going to have a music video play on the podcast at Haramcore Plays. And it's going to be Zygnema's I Am Nothing. Check it out. Thank you so much, guys, for being a part of the podcast.
Thank you, man. Thank you for having us.
And yeah, man, like it's been great. Episode 16 comes to a wrap. You're checking out Zygnema's I Am Nothing. This is Haramcore Plays. Stay Haramcore.
Stay Haramcore.